Grab the little one.
You're right about that.
Uh-oh.
You gotta fill it up.
It's all
pretty steady.
Quarter of a ton.
Wow.
Hey, thank you.
Yeah. yet swell the chorus of the Union, and again touched as surely as they will be by the better angels of our nature. 4 years have passed since then, in 1851, and now the time is March 1865, my second inaugural. I wrote these words to help heal the wounds of the Civil War. The words go as such: with malice towards none, with charity for all, with firmness in the right as God gives us to see the right, let us strive on to finish the work that we are in, to bind up the nation's wounds, to care for him who shall have borne the battle, and for his widow and his orphan, to do all which may achieve and cherish a just and lasting peace among ourselves and with all nations.
Maybe I have a brother-in-law that might care for that. Very nice work, Mr. President. I would ask you to remain standing here and silent as we lay a wreath at the grave to commemorate the passing of those who have given their all for this country.
Attention, detail. Shoulder. Earth. Reset.
Ladies and gentlemen, friends, in October, in 1868, General John Logan had proclaimed May 30th as a day designated to decorate, to strew with flowers or decorate any grave for our heroes who had gave their lives for the Union cause. It was known as Decoration Day. Today we know it as Memorial Day, a day where we honor all of Americans who had sacrificed all. They had the full, fullest measure. They gave up their tomorrows that we might have today. They say that a soldier dies three deaths. The first time when his soul leaves his physical body. The second time when that body is laid to rest in the earth. The third time when his name is whispered for the very last time. Friends, before you go off on this kickoff of summer, Memorial Day weekend, before you go to the beach, that barbecue, picnic, ball game, sale of the year, stop and remember why we have this day. Who gave us this day? I would ask you to, before you do any of these other things, take a minute and go visit your local cemetery. Look at the dates. Look for the flags. You'll know who the veterans are, the soldiers. You'll know by the dates who paid that ultimate sacrifice. I would ask that you just take a moment to remember them. And perhaps say their name out loud just one more time so that their memory has not passed and their deeds will not be forgotten. That concludes our ceremony for today. Thank you.
I really hope all of these have saved my camera. This is not a reject. Time to find out. Oh!
He's standing the wrong way.